हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ संजय पाटिल एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सेकेंड यूनिट फ्रॉम बेसिक मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग विच इज़ रिलेटेड टू मशीन्स एंड मैकेनिक्स, देन फैक्टर ऑफ सेफ्टी, इंट्रोडक्शन टू वेरियस मशीन्स, देर इंजीनियरिंग मटेरियल्स. नाउ आवर कंटेंट ऑफ द प्रेजेंटेशन आर मशीन एंड मैकेनिज्म, then factor of safety, engineering material, introduction to fasteners, then introduction to machinability, introduction to lathe machine, introduction to drilling machine, and finally introduction to milling machine. Now let's start with machine and mechanism. Okay, so machine can be defined as it is a combination of rigid or resistant bodies formed and connected so that they move with definite relative motions and transmit force from the source of power to the resistance to be overcome. A machine has two functions: transmitting definite relative motion and transmitting force. These functions require strength and rigidity to transmit the forces. Examples of machines: lathe machine, drilling machine, milling machine, where source of power is a three-phase motor. So by using this three-phase motor, we are going to create force, and we used to transmit the force, right? Then mechanism is applied to combination of geometrical bodies which constitute a machine or part of a machine. A mechanism may be therefore defined as a combination of rigid or resistant bodies formed and connected so that they move with definite relative motions with respect to one another. The difference between machine and mechanism is that machines transform energy to do work, while mechanism so not necessarily perform this function. So basically a machine will consist of various mechanisms. Okay, so a machine will perform its work by a combination of these mechanism. Now example of mechanism is, we have seen in IC engine, the mechanism of office crank link, cylinder link crank part is a, in that particular cylinder link crank, a slider clank mechanism is used. So it is a type of mechanism, slider crank mechanism, to get the motion in case of IC engine. Then next point is factor of safety. So now factor of safety is considered while selection of material, while designing of calculations, or while performing certain calculations, factor of safety has to be considered. So when you design a component, a load that a component has to carry during its service is calculated taking into consideration of all the possible loads that might act on it. This calculated load is known as design load. So as I told you earlier, that if we want to design a machine, then first of all we have to select proper material. So on that particular component, which is made of that particular material, various forces will be acting. So we have to identify the types of forces that are acting on that particular component, and we have to find out its value, how much intensity of that particular forces or that particular stresses they are acting on that particular component. Now factor of safety is designed as the ratio of yield stress to working stress for ductile material. Okay, so for ductile material, factor of safety is yield stress divided by working stress. So every material has a definite yield stress value, and working stress means the stress, the amount of stress that will be produced while performing the work. Okay, and for brittle materials, which has no well defined yield point, the factor of safety is calculated based on ultimate stress. So factor of safety for brittle material is defined as ultimate stress divided by working stress. Now next point is engineering material. So as I have said earlier, for designing a particular machine or particular component, we should be familiar with various engineering materials. We should know the various properties of materials. So now in this slide you can see the various materials like metals, under metals there are certain types like ferrous material, in that carbon steel, low carbon steel, low alloy steel, tool steel, stainless steel, cast iron. Okay, next metal is aluminium alloys, then nickel alloys, copper alloys, titanium alloys. So all these are under metals. The next is polymers, in that thermoplastic polymers, then thermosetting polymers and elastomers. Then in case of ceramics, then it will consist of glass, cements, clay products, refractories, abrasives. Refractories are used where high temperature is there and we have to protect that particular part, or we have seen refractories are used in boilers to protect against the high temperature. Then composites, in that particulate composites, then fibrous composites and laminated composites. So we can combine properties of two or more materials in case of composites. Now next point is fasteners. Fasteners are nothing but the universal components used to create non-permanent joint. In other words, they will simplify the manufacture of structures and machines, being reduces the need for larger parts. Fasteners are normally easier to design, less complex components, and even fasten them together. So we have seen many types of fasteners like bolts, nuts, screws, nails. Okay, so first is bolts. These are supposed to be threaded lengths made of steel rods with heads on single end, and another end will be threaded one. Bolts are generally used along with nuts at other end, and every so often with washer too. So nuts and bolts are used with washer. Then bolts are of four types, including carriage bolt, then cap screw, hexagonal bolt and plow bolts. Okay, the nuts are flat steel pieces, usually hexagonal in shape, with internally cut threads. Types: hexagonal nuts, square nuts, castle nuts. These are the types of nuts. Then washers. Washers are mainly divided into types, mainly a plain washer or a flat washer and split lock washer. Washers are generally steel discs having a hole in the center. So these types are used to minimize the stress present in the bolt and nuts. They can able to spread a clamping force right from the bolt to span slot in order to oversize the holes in the wood. Basically, the function of washer is to it can spread the pressure equally throughout the area. That is the function of washer. Helical spring washers or lock washers are normally made from tough spring steels and installed under the bolt or nut. They are utilized to protect nuts from rotation. And finally, nails are none other than steel rods, which are usually pointed at one end and having a head at another end. Nails are primarily used to join woods together. The size of the nails is generally referred in terms of penny. Common nails are box nails, finish nails, duplex nails, roofing nails. These are some types of nails. Then screws. So just like bolts, screws too are threaded lengths of rods made of steel with head on one end. The heads of the screw may be slotted, square, cross, slotted or hexagonal. The types of screw include slotted flat head, slotted round head, slotted oval head, Phillips drive and square drive. So these are the various examples of fasteners. Next point is machinability. So machinability can be defined as it is the ease with which a metal can be cut or machined, permitting the removal of the metal with a satisfactory finish at low cost. That means with how much ease we can remove the material. That is called as machinability. So materials with good machinability requires little power to cut and can be cut quickly, easily obtained a good finish and do not wear the tooling much. So that is the identity of good material having good machinability. The factors that typically improve the material's performance often degrade its machinability. Therefore, to manufacture a component economically, engineers are challenged to find ways to improve machinability without harming performance. Machinability is defined in terms of surface finish and surface integrity. So how much surface finish we can achieve by using that particular tool on that particular material. Then tool life, the specific tool used to machine. Third is force and power required to machine. And fourth is level of difficulty in chip removal. So these are the four parameters which are used to define machinability for the particular material. So good machinability indicates good surface finish and good surface integrity, a long tool life and a low force and power requirement. So machinability ratings or index are available for each type of material and its condition. So every material has its own particular machinability index. So you can get that in a manual. The next factors affecting machinability. First one is material of workpiece, its hardness, tensile properties, then stain hardened ability of that particular material or workpiece. Second, tool material, the tool which we are going to use for machining, then size and shape of the tool, geometry of the tool we have to consider, then type of machining operation that we are performing, then size, shape and velocity of the cut, then type and quality of machine use, that is also important, then quality of lubricant use in machining, then friction between chip and tool. So if at all there is a friction between chip and tool, we will not get a good surface finish. So it will hamper the machinability of that particular metal. And last is shearing strength of the workpiece material. So machinability index can be calculated as VT divided by VS multiplied by 100. VT is cutting speed of the metal for 1 minute of tool life, and VS is cutting speed of the standard free cutting steel for 1 minute of tool life. So this is how a machinability index can be calculated for each material or each metal. So